We give you the opportunity to listen one of our last interesting topics for today. And I think it's well known that every business needs the words big and smart data. And our next speaker emphasizes the importance of tackling this issue in automation. And he also will talk about where the challenges of connected sensors and the cloud could lie. Not only theoretical, I can guarantee you that, it will be explained vividly based on applications and possible solutions. Go from sensor into the cloud, we welcome Udo Huneke.
Yeah, thanks a lot. But before we start, I would like to ask you a question.
Sure.
You are now the second day here on the show, and I believe you walked through the hallways.
Yes. Yeah.
How do you feel about all the statements you see here, like cloud, 5G, artificial intelligence, and all these buzzwords you hear?
I hope I don't have to be specific, because I think it's really overwhelming, to be honest. You know, you read all the signs, all the words, intelligence and stuff, and industry 4.0. I think it's really overwhelming and difficult to understand it in detail, to be honest.
Yeah, and that's a little bit what we feel as well when we are talking with our customers. We see all these buzzwords here on the show, and of course we are using these buzzwords as well, yeah, for sure. And one of the major buzzwords at the moment is 5G and artificial intelligence. Interesting to me when I realized that 5G in general will be maybe available in 2 to 3 years. At the moment we are at the beginning technological level from this technology. And what we see is a lot of these buzzwords, and we thought about, we are not making a presentation with all these buzzwords. We want to talk with you a little bit about how you can be successful with an IoT project, where you should look about and maybe not look about, and how our feeling and our statement about it is. And we believe it's very important to figure out what do you and your company want to achieve? Do you have some knowledge about all the topics you need? What improvements do you expect for yourself and for your company? And what kind of infrastructure is existing? Yeah, and you can see all the buzzwords. We want to go away from that a little bit. One important statement from our side is size matters. Everybody is talking about big data, smart data, and the difference to be successful at the moment is, in our opinion, you need the right people to make a project to a success. Yeah, and therefore, we believe successful projects motivate to take the next steps. From our opinion, you should start with small projects, because having the first success, it will improve your motivation to take the next steps. As well, getting the right partners on board. Do you have all the knowledge to cover all the topics? We made a project in our warehouse, and we figured out that connecting data to an SAP system, as an example, we are not experts in that. So we were looking for the right partner to make it successful, and we found somebody, and therefore finding the right strategic partnerships to make a project to a success is, from our point of view, very important. That does not mean that we are the right partner. It depends on the topic. It depends on what you want to achieve to make it really successful. As an example, and I'm sorry for this German screenshot, we figured out that in our automatic warehouse, we have three important values to identify if the automatic warehouse is running successfully, or if we have to make a maintenance shortly in the future. Yeah? We detect the belt, the strength of the belt. If the strength of the belt is passing a certain border to the top or to the bottom, then it's an indication for the point, there's a service necessary. Yeah? The second point is humidity, and the third point is temperature. With these three values, we can detect how the health of our warehouse is. Of course, there could be much more, but we were looking to what kind of failures did we have mostly in the past, and we were looking for a first point to improve this. And therefore, these three values are important. Big data or smart data. Yes, you can collect everything and put it into the warehouse, but maybe it's like this. You have it somewhere, and then you are looking for what is right, when do I need it, yeah? All what you collect, it has to be stored, it has to be sent, it has to be administrated, it has to be secured. Look really for the important things, yeah? So we are more on the way of smart data instead of big data, taking the right selected data which brings you an improvement in your situation. A typical way to connecting a machine to a cloud is that you want to connect it to a cloud, and now you have to pass the data through different levels of the machine infrastructure. Yeah, historically we have a machine, we have maybe connected it with a modem to get somewhere the data. Now we have a mixture of operational technology and information technology. We have to go through all these different levels to bring the data to the right point. In addition, changing this and connecting this, there's an old statement, never touch a running system. Yeah? Taking data out of the machine can mean that there's a change of performance or whatever. Take care of that, maybe afterwards it's not running any longer, yeah? And to give you again a short overview, historically, you have to go through all these different kind of levels to bring the data, as an example, to an ERP system, yeah? Complicated, or it sounds complicated, you need the IT, and therefore we thought about we need a different way to approach this. We decided to put we call it NexoGate, a listening module. This module is just listening what kind of data will be transferred here, and is bypassing the PLC to transfer the selected data where you decide this could be important for you to transfer that to a gateway and management cloud. What is a gateway and management cloud? First of all, it manages the communication on this way. Yeah, we use GSM that you can handle it wherever you want. Yeah, 3G. 3G while everybody is talking about 5G on the show. Yes, I'm sorry to say that we are here in Germany and 4G is not every time available at every point, and 5G is even not available at the moment except of the show here. So we were looking to 3G, and having taken the decision to transfer just selected data, that means we are not talking about gigabytes of data, 3G is absolutely appropriate enough to cover that. So we bypass the PLC, transfer it with this listening module to cloud, and that means you can use this data on any smartphone, on any tablet, on any browser, wherever you are in the world. And it means as well, you can send messages to your maintenance guys in case of this failure happens, the right maintenance guy get a message. He has to confirm that he reached the message and maybe is working on this. And you can figure later on out, yes, he got the info, he has accepted it, he's dealing with it. So this supports as well the point, it doesn't matter where a machine is located. As long as you have a 3G signal, you can put the machine everywhere in the world, because we thought it must be flexible. That means there's a global SIM card behind. You can use it in approximately 200 countries with approximately 400 providers. It takes the best signals to it takes the best signal strength to transfer it to the cloud. Don't forget security. Yeah, we see in a lot of cases that customers want to deal with it in that way, that they develop everything themselves. You can do that, of course, but don't forget the security issues, because every network can be hacked. Yeah, we have an encryption included that from the Nexo gate to the cloud, there's an AES 256 encryption, which is standard at the moment. And the standard to go to the cloud and watch these messages is TLS 1.2. It's as well the common standard on the market. So we have decided to take the known and common standards in to have the security insight you need. Important is, if we talk about this, who is the owner of the data? Yeah. We see us as a service provider for technology and the cloud, but we feel as well the customer is owning the data. That are not our data, yeah, because we just providing a service with the cloud and with the gateways and so on. Okay, a short overview to what we did in our warehouse. Yeah, we made as well this connection to SAP. We are using for a long, long time already SAP. So we decided we want to have this data not in this management cloud. We want to have it even in the higher level of the our ERP system. In that case, SAP could be every ERP system of the world. It doesn't matter. And for that, as I said, we need partners. We required a partner to bring it into SAP because it's not our strength. We provided the data at an interface of the cloud. He has taken this data and copied it into SAP so that we have all these messages in-house as well for SAP available. So, what's the potential? You have to think about what really gives you a benefit out of that. These are just a few points. Yes, of course, you can use it globally. Yes, of course, these are just modules which are listening. So you are not changing a running machine. You can just add it. Yeah. Remote system connection is possible without an additional infrastructure. Of course, you need a 3G signal. Of course, you need voltage. Yeah, if that's not given, it will not run, of course. with this as well, it's a starting point. You can start with a very small project to figure out with a small investment, how can I get a benefit out of it? Yeah. Yeah, the data can be worldwide available. And we just want to see or tell you this because we see this as a starting point to make IoT projects more common on the market and not just only with these buzzwords. And if you are interested in, we can show you all that on the rear side of this wall because that is in real life. Otherwise, I would like to say thank you very much for being here. And I would be done because we agreed just having a few minutes.
So true, Mr. Hunicke. Thank you very much. Does someone of you have maybe questions regarding from sensor into the cloud? I guess not, but I think, Mr. Hunicke, it's very important what you said, and I want to ask you that again because it's a very important point. Which software tools do you need for this?
In that case, we don't need any software tool because the cloud has a web interface. And in this web interface, you can make the connection, you can create a dashboard. We do not have any additional software which has to be installed on your computer.
And I think also a very important point, you talked about collecting data, or better, not collecting data. So who owns the data if he's working together with Murrelektronik?
Okay, I can just point out again, in our opinion, it's pretty clear we are providing hardware modules, we are providing services, we are providing a cloud, but the data are data of the customer and should stay as data of the customer. We are not interested in this data.
I think very important point. So good that you pointed it out again. So thank you.
You're welcome. Thank you.
And ladies and gentlemen, this was our last presentation for today.